Welcome to today's episode on practical. In today's experiment, we will learn to study the setting and using a chemical balance. Chalo sab to pehla assi weighing techniques de bare jaande haan. Par is to pehla let us have acquaintance with the analytical balance or the chemical balance. The construction and principle of working of a chemical balance are same as that of a physical balance. However, is the higher sensitivity hone de karan, is the accuracy vi zyada hundi hai. With the help of a chemical balance, one can weigh accurately up to 4 places of decimal. Analytical balance can be used to weigh mass of substance up to 0.0002 grams accuracy. It is called the least count of the balance. A full view of a two-pan analytical chemical balance is shown on the screen.
Bachyo, is prakar de balance vich beam kise sakht par halke padarat da banya hunda hai. The beam is made up of a hard but lightweight material. The beam pivots at its center on a knife edge which rests upon a plate made of very hard material such as agate or corundum. The plate is attached to the central beam support acting as central pillar. The two terminal agate knife edges are fixed at equal distance from the central edge and each of these supports a suspension called stirrup from which the pans are hung. A sharp pointer is attached to the center of the beam. Jivein ke tusi screen te vekh rahe ho ke beam de madh vich ik sharp pointer attach kita janda hai. The pointer moves over a scale fixed at the bottom of the pillar and serves to point out the deflection of the beam from central position when the balance is in operation as shown on the screen. There are two adjusting screws on both sides of the beam, which are meant for adjusting the beam in the horizontal position. Jivein ke tusi screen te vekh rahe ho ke beam de dono passe adjustment karan layi pech lagge hunde han jinna rahi beam nu horizontal position vich rakhan layi adjustment kiti jandi hai. There are three leveling screws at the base of the balance to make it horizontal. A plumb line hangs near the central pillar jo ke balance nu horizontal position vich rakhan layi help karda hai. In order to operate the balance, there is a knob at the center of the base. Let us now learn about weight box including fractional weights and riders. Bachyo, the weight box of a chemical balance generally contains the weights listed on screen in three categories. Weights for weighing in grams: 100, 50, 20, 20, 10, 5, 2, 2, 1. Weights for weighing in milligrams: 500, 200, 200, 100, 50, 20, 20, 10. Rider, to weigh 0.2 milligram to 10 milligram. Chemical balance which weight karan diyan tin categories nu screen te vikhaya ja reha hai. Materials used for making the weights are as gram weights, made of copper and nickel with or without coating of chromium. Milligram weights, made of aluminium, German silver or stainless steel. Rider, a loop made of aluminium or platinum wire weighing 10 milligram.
Children, let us now learn about setting of a chemical balance and weighing. The material required are chemical balance 1, weight box 1, set of fractional weights including rider 1, weighing bottle or watch glass 1.
Chalo bachyo, hun asi procedure bare jaande haan. Children, chemical balance nu use karan layi kuch steps nu follow karan di lod hundi hai. Chalo, ena steps bare jaande haan. These steps can be listed as level the balance with the help of leveling screws and plumb line. Nishchit kar lo ki beam horizontal position vich hai. Beam de dove passe ditte gaye screws di help nal pointer nu adjust karke 0 point te adjust karo. If it is adjusted on releasing the beam arrest, the pointer moves equal divisions on both the sides of the zero of the base scale. Place a watch glass or a weighing bottle on the left pan in which weighing material is kept. Put approximate weights from the weight box with the help of forceps on the right pan. Hun beam nu slowly release karo ate scale te pointer di movement nu note karo. Jekar is the weight approximate na hove ta pointer halke wale passe move karega. Add or remove weights according to the requirement after bringing the pans to rest by arresting the beam with the help of the knob located near the base. When weight on both the pans becomes equal, the pointer moves equal divisions on both sides of the zero of the base scale. Use the rider for adjustment of weight below 10 milligram. Bachyo, aao hun asi rider di varton bare jaande haan. Rider di help nal asi maximum 10 milligram tak da weight weigh kar sakde haan. Rider da apna weight vi 10 milligram hunda hai. It can be easily placed in the grooves of the balance beam. When placed at the terminal position of the beam, which is marked 10, it will weigh 10 milligrams. That is 0.01 grams. Principle of movement is applied for weighing by using the rider. Weight is equal to the arm length from the center of the beam multiplied by the weight of the rider. Length of the beam from the center to the one side of the beam is taken as unit length. On both sides from the center, the balance beam is divided into 10 equal parts through equidistant marks, each of which corresponds to 1 by 10 of the length of the beam. Is tarah, each big 1 division corresponds to 1 by 10 into 0.01 grams, which is equal to 0.01 0.001 gram or 1 milligram weight. Each big division is further divided into 5 parts. Thus, each small division corresponds to only 1 by 5 milligrams, that is 0.2 milligram or 0.0002 gram. Isliye, the rider placed at the 4.2 mark will weigh 0.0044 gram, that is 4 multiplied by 0.001 plus 2 multiplied by 0.0002 equals to 0.0044 gram.
ਚਿਲਡਰਨ ਚਲੋ ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਕਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਸਾਵਧਾਨੀਆਂ ਵਰਤਣੀਆਂ ਚਾਹੀਦੀਆਂ ਹਨ ਪੈਨਸ ਮਸਟ ਬੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰਲੀ ਕਲੀਨਡ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਐਂਡ ਆਫਟਰ ਵੇਇੰਗ ਕੈਮੀਕਲਸ ਸ਼ੁੱਡ ਨੈਵਰ ਬੀ ਪਲੇਸਡ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਲੀ ਔਨ ਦ ਪੈਨਸ ਫੋਰ ਵੇਇੰਗ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਰਿਲੀਜ਼ ਦ ਬੀਮ ਜੈਂਟਲੀ ਅਵੋਇਡ ਓਵਰਲੋਡਿੰਗ ਦ ਬੈਲੈਂਸ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਸਫਰ ਦ ਵੇਟਸ from one place to another with the help of forceps. Do not allow the weights to get spoiled by corrosion. Never weigh a hot or cold object on the balance. Always keep weights on the right pan and object on the left pan of the balance if you are a right-handed person. Always make necessary adjustments in the balance before weighing. To insert or remove weights and to keep the objects on the pans, always use the side doors. Never use the front shutter. Keep the doors shut while releasing the beam arrest to note the movement of the pointer on the scale. Now that we have learned so much, let me ask you a few questions. My first question is, why should the weights not be lifted by hand? And the answer is, this causes error in the weighing because some matter may be transferred from the hand to the weight. My next question is, why is the front door of the balance closed during weighing? And the answer is, opening the front door causes vibrations in the pan due to operator's breath or air currents, which leads to inaccurate results. Next question is, what is the maximum weight that can be weighed in a chemical balance? The answer is, the maximum weight that can be weighed in a chemical balance is 100 grams. Next question is, what is the weight of a rider? And the answer is, the weight of a rider is 10 milligrams. Next question is, what is the use of the rider? And the answer is, a rider is used for weights less than 10 milligrams. Children, let us now learn about preparation of 250 milliliter of 0.1 molar standard solution of oxalic acid. Let us now learn about the theory behind it. A solution of exactly known concentration is considered to be a standard solution. There are various ways of expressing the concentration of a standard solution. Standard solution of an acid or base is used to determine the unknown concentration of a solution of bases or acids by volumetric analysis. For example, a standard solution of oxalic acid can be used to determine the unknown concentration of an alkali solution. The strength of a standard solution is usually expressed in moles per liter.
Bachyo, tusi screen te hydrated crystalline oxalic acid da formula vekh rahe ho. Is da molar mass 126 gram hai. Jekar 1 liter solution vich 126 gram oxalic acid present hove, ta isnu 1 molar ja 1.0 m solution keha janda hai. 1 liter of 0.1 m oxalic acid solution prepare karan layi, we require 126 upon 10, which is equal to 12.6 gram of hydrated oxalic acid. Isse tarah, for preparing 250 milliliter of 0.1 m oxalic acid solution, we require 12.6 gram multiplied by 250 milliliter divided by 1000 milliliter, which is equal to 3.1500 gram of hydrated oxalic acid. In general, for preparing a solution of required molarity, the amount of substance to be weighed can be calculated by using the formula given on screen. Molarity represented as capital M is equal to mass of the solute in grams multiplied by 1000 divided by molar mass of solute multiplied by volume of solution to be prepared in milliliter.
Children, the material required for the experiment are measuring flask 250 milliliter 1, funnel 1, weighing tube or watch glass 1, wash bottle 1, iron stand with ring clamp 1, oxalic acid as per need.
Is experiment nu karan da procedure is tarah hai. Ek khali clean ate dry watch glass ja weighing tube nu accurately weigh karo. Label it as weight 1. Weigh 3.1500 gram oxalic acid by placing it on the watch glass or in a weighing tube and label it as weight 2. Hamesha decimal de 4th place tak weight note karna chahida hai and clean the balance before and after weighing the chemical. Hun watch glass ja weighing tube vichon oxalic acid nu ek funnel di varton karde hoye ek clean and dry measuring flask vich carefully transfer karo. Khali watch glass da fir vazan karo. Label it as weight 3 and find out the mass of oxalic acid transferred to the measuring flask by subtracting this mass, that is weight 3, from the combined mass of watch glass and oxalic acid, that is weight 2. Is mass dwara solution the exact molarity da pata lagao. Wash funnel several times with distilled water by using a wash bottle to transfer the sticking particles, if any, into the measuring flask. While washing the funnel, pani di kat matra add karo, taki is the flask which volume ਮੇਜ਼ਰਿੰਗ ਫਲਾਸਕ ਦੇ ਵੋਲਿਊਮ ਦੇ 1/4 ਤੋਂ ਐਕਸੀਡ ਨਾ ਕਰੇ, ਜਿਸ ਪ੍ਰਕਾਰ ਕਿ ਸਕਰੀਨ 'ਤੇ ਵਿਖਾਇਆ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈ। ਸਵਰਲ ਦਾ ਮੇਜ਼ਰਿੰਗ ਫਲਾਸਕ ਟਿਲ ਸੋਲਿਡ ਆਕਸੈਲਿਕ ਐਸਿਡ ਇਜ਼ ਕੰਪਲੀਟਲੀ ਡਿਸੋਲਵਡ। ਐਡ ਮੋਰ ਡਿਸਟਿਲਡ ਵਾਟਰ ਵਿਦ ਸ਼ੇਕਿੰਗ। ਮੇਕਅਪ ਦਾ ਵੋਲਿਊਮ ਵਿਦ ਡਿਸਟਿਲਡ ਵਾਟਰ ਟੂ ਦਾ ਐਚਡ ਮਾਰਕ ਬਾਏ ਐਡਿੰਗ ਲਾਸਟ ਫਿਊ ਮਿਲੀਲੀਟਰ ਡ੍ਰੋਪ ਵਾਈਜ਼। ਸਟੋਪਰ ਦਾ ਫਲਾਸਕ ਐਂਡ ਸ਼ੇਕ ਇਟ ਥੋਰਲੀ ਟੂ ਮੇਕ ਦਾ ਸੋਲਿਊਸ਼ਨ ਯੂਨੀਫੋਰਮ ਥਰੂ ਆਊਟ ਐਸ ਸ਼ੋਨ ਔਨ ਸਕਰੀਨ। ਲੇਬਲ ਇਟ ਐਸ 0.1 mL ਆਕਸੈਲਿਕ ਐਸਿਡ ਸੋਲਿਊਸ਼ਨ।
Children, now that we have learned so much, let us learn about the precautions. The pan of the balance should be cleaned before and after weighing. Never touch the weights with hand. Use forceps to transfer weights from the weight box to the pan of the balance. Always use spatula to transfer the reagent from the bottle onto the watch glass. Stopper the reagent bottle immediately after withdrawing the substance. Always use distilled water to prepare the standard solution. Always check the adjustment of the balance before weighing the substance. Care should be taken while weighing the chemicals. These should not be spilled on the pan of the balance. Watch glass or weighing bottle and funnel should be washed several times by using small amounts of distilled water each time. While making the solution, water should be added carefully so that the lower part of the meniscus just touches the etched mark of the measuring flask. To ensure uniform composition of the solution, stopper the flask and shake it carefully and thoroughly. Children, now that we have learned so much, let me ask you few questions. How is an analytical balance different from a physical balance? And the answer is, the analytical balance is different from a physical balance as it can be used for weighing objects not heavier than 100 to 200 grams of precision of 0.002 grams, that is 0.2 milligrams. Next question is, why is front door of the balance closed during weighing? And the answer is, opening of front door causes vibrations in the pan due to the operator's breath or air currents, which leads to inaccurate results. Next question is, on what principle is weighing by using rider based? And the answer is, principle of movement is applied for weighing by using the rider. Next question is, which weights are called fractional weights? And the answer is, fractional weights include 500 milligrams, 200 milligrams, 100 milligrams, 50 milligrams, 20 milligrams, 10 milligrams, 5 milligrams, 2 milligrams and 1 milligrams weight. Next question is, what is the weight of a rider? And the answer is, the weight of the rider is 10 milligrams. Next question is, why are forceps always used for handling the weights? And the answer is, to get more accurate results, forceps are used for handling the weights. Weights should not be lifted with hand because some matter may be transferred from the hand to the weight. Next question is, the rider rests at a reading of 3.4 on the left side of the beam. What contribution does this make to the weight of the material being weighed when weights are placed on the right pan? And the answer is, the rider placed at the 3.4 mark on the left side of the beam will weigh 0.0038 grams, that is 3 into 0.001 plus 4 into 0.0002, that equals to 0.0038 grams. Next question is, what do you mean by a molar solution? And the answer is, a solution containing 1 gram mole of solute per liter of solution is called molar solution. Next question is, what is a normal solution? And the answer is, a normal solution is a solution a liter of which contains 1 gram equivalent of the solute. Next question is, why are the standard solutions always prepared in a volumetric flask? And the answer is, volumetric flask has a mark around the neck and it helps in avoiding errors which can take place in the final adjustment of meniscus. My next question is, can solid sodium hydroxide be used to prepare its standard solution? And the answer is, solid sodium hydroxide cannot be used to prepare its standard solution as it is not possible to weigh in accurately. Solid sodium hydroxide is hydroscopic in nature. My next question is, what type of substance can be used for preparing standard solution? And the answer is, a substance which is easily available, neither hydroscopic nor deliquescent and highly soluble in water can be used for preparing standard solution.
How much KMnO4 is required to prepare 250 milliliter of 0.02 molar solution? Molarity equals to moles per liter. Convert 250 milliliter to liter. Divide it by 1000, which is equals to 0.25 liter. 0.02 molar equals to moles by 0.25. Moles equals to 0.02 molar into 0.25. Moles equals to 0.05 moles KMnO4. Convert from moles to grams using molar mass. Molar mass of KMnO4 equals to 100.0341 grams per moles. 0.05 moles KMnO4, 158.0341 grams upon 1 moles equals to 7.90 grams equals to 8.00 gram potassium permanganate.
Children, I hope I have made a successful attempt in explaining today's practical to you. See you in the next class. Bye.